नमस्कार। नाउ वील स्टार्ट विथ लंग। लंग इज अ सॉफ्ट ब्रिटल एंड इट इज इलास्टिक इन नेचर। इट इज अ स्पॉन्ज लाइक स्ट्रक्चर। इट इज शेप ऑफ लंग जस्ट लाइक अ कोन, हाफ कोन। इन अडल्ट कलर ऑफ लंग इज ब्लैक बिकॉज ऑफ डिपोजिशन ऑफ कार्बन पार्टिकल्स इन साइड दिस लंग। एंड दिस लंग इट फ्लोट्स ऑन वॉटर बिकॉज ऑफ प्रेजेंस ऑफ एयर इन साइड दिस लंग। बट इन स्टील बॉर्न दिस लंग कैन गो इन इन साइड इन दिस वॉटर। नाउ विल सी ग्रॉस फीचर्स ऑफ दिस लंग। पार्ट्स ऑफ लंग। लंग विल शो अपेक्स, बेस, कॉस्टल सरफेस, मीडियल सरफेस, एंटीरियर बॉर्डर, पोस्टीरियर बॉर्डर एंड इन्फीरियर बॉर्डर। विल सी ऑल दीज पार्ट्स वन बाय वन। अपेक्स, इट इज अपर मोस्ट कोनिकल पार्ट ऑफ लंग। इट लाइज अबव फर्स्ट कॉस्टल कार्टिलेज और यू कैन से अबव क्लेविकल। इट इज नियर अबाउट 2.5 सेंटीमीटर अबव दिस क्लेविकल। इट इज कवर्ड बाय सर्वाइकल प्लूरा एंड सुप्रा प्लूरल मेम्ब्रेन। दिस अपेक्स इट इज ग्रूव्ड बाय सब क्लेवियन आर्टरी एंड सब क्लेवियन वेन। अपेक्स इज अपर पार्ट। नाउ बेस। बेस इज लोअर कॉनकेव पार्ट ऑफ लंग। दिस कॉनकेविटी इज मोर प्रोमिनंट इन राइट लंग बिकॉज इन रिलेशन विद दिस राइट लंग देर इज प्रेजेंस ऑफ लीवर। अपेक्स, बेस। नाउ नेक्स्ट इज कॉस्टल सरफेस। कॉस्टल सरफेस ऑफ लंग। दिस कॉस्टल सरफेस इट इज आउटर कर्व सरफेस ऑफ दिस लंग। इट कम्स इन रिलेशन विथ रिब्स, इंटरकॉस्टल स्पेसेस एंड इन बिटवीन दिस देर इज प्रेजेंस ऑफ इंडोथोरेसिक फेशिया एंड प्लूरा। These ribs and intercostal spaces create impressions in relation with this costal surface. Intercostal space forms elevation and ribs will form depression. Therefore, depressed part is formed by ribs and elevated part in relation with this costal surface is formed by intercostal space. Now, this costal surface comes in relation with upper six ribs in mid-clavicular line, then upper eight ribs in relation with mid-axillary line, upper 10 ribs in relation with scapular line. These are relations of this costal surface. Now here, medial surface. Later on, we'll cover medial surface. Before this, we'll see borders, because medial surface shows different features. Therefore, I will cover this surface later on. First, borders: anterior border, posterior border and inferior border. Anterior border. Anterior border, it is a sharp border and it lies in relation with posterior aspect of sternum. And it corresponds to the anterior line of pleural reflection, costo-mediastinal reflection of pleura. And it shows a deep notch in relation with left lung, posterior to fifth costal cartilage, mainly formed by pericardium containing heart. This is anterior border. Now posterior border, it is a rounded border, ill-defined border, and it comes in relation with heads of upper 10 ribs. Here, last border is inferior border. Inferior border is thin and sharp border. This border separates base of lung from costal and medial surface. And this inferior border also comes in relation with costo-diaphragmatic recess of pleura. We can see here all these parts of lungs, including its surfaces, apex, base, borders. Now, medial surface in detail. Medial surface, it shows two parts, vertebral part and mediastinal part. This vertebral part, it lies in relation with, or you can say it is posterior part of this medial surface. It lies or it comes in relation with upper 10 thoracic vertebra with its intervertebral discs. Now, anterior part of this medial surface is mediastinal surface. This mediastinal surface shows different structures in right and left lung. Which structures present in relation with this mediastinal part of this medial surface? First, right lung. In right lung, hilum. Hilum, it is a triangular part in which some structure enters inside lung, some structures come out of this lung. Now, inside this hilum of right lung, from above downward, which structures present? First, from above downward, upper lobe bronchus, pulmonary artery, right principal bronchus, then last one is lower pulmonary vein, means bronchus, artery, bronchus, vein. These four structures present in relation with this hilum of right lung, but anterior to posterior, same structures in this hilum, vein, artery and bronchus. This is about its structure present in hilum. In addition to the area around this hilum, there is presence of cardiac impression in which right ventricle, part of right auricle and right atrium will comes in relation with this cardiac impression. Remaining structures, right phrenicna also comes in relation with this. Superior vena cava present in relation with upper aspect of this cardiac impression. Inferior vena cava just below that. Above, in relation with superior vena cava, there is presence of one arch depressed line. This is for arch of azygous vein. Just near to this, there is presence of brachiocephalic trunk. Now, in relation with this upper part, there is presence of impression for trachea with vagus nerve. And in relation with this posterior part of this, there is presence of impression for esophagus. This is about right lung. Now, left lung. In left lung, again hilum. Which structure present in hilum? First, from above downward, pulmonary artery, left principal bronchus, lower pulmonary vein, means artery, bronchus, vein, from above downward. Anterior to posterior, vein, artery, bronchus in hilum. Now, remaining relations, which structures comes in relation with remaining part of this surface? Cardiac impression, it is a deep prominent in left lung, and this impression comes in relation with this left ventricle, part of right ventricle, right auricle. Then in relation with this upper part, there is presence of one impression for pulmonary trunk. Above this cardiac impression and posterior aspect, first above arch of aorta, which will continue as a descending thoracic aorta. It is a continuous depressed line. Depression for arch of aorta and descending thoracic aorta. Also, left phrenic nerve and left vagus nerve where there is crossing of these two nerves takes place just above aorta, comes in relation with this surface. Left brachiocephalic vein comes in relation with this medial aspect. Then esophagus comes in relation with upper part, in relation with posterior aspect, upper and lower part. In relation with esophagus, there is presence of thoracic duct. This is about relations of this medial surface, mediastinal part. Now next is lobes and fissures of lung. In right lung, three lobes present: upper, middle, lower. Two fissures present, oblique and horizontal. In left lung, two lobes present, upper and lower. One fissure present, oblique fissure. Now oblique fissure, this oblique fissure in relation with right lung. What happens in relation with this lung? It will start posterior to this hilum. It will go back and up to level of fifth thoracic vertebra. Then it crosses this outer surface, costal surface of this lung, and in relation with fifth intercostal space, it goes antero inferiorly by forming a spiral course and meet with inferior margin of lung near sixth intercostal space, where in relation with sixth costochondral junction, cutting of this with inferior margin of lung will take place. This is oblique fissure. Now horizontal fissure. Horizontal fissure is present only in right lung. In left lung, there is no horizontal fissure. It extends from anterior margin of lung at the level of fourth costal cartilage. It runs horizontally backward and it meet with oblique fissure in the mid axillary line. Therefore, in right lung, three lobes are formed, and in left lung, only one fissure is present. Therefore, only two lobes are present in left lung. In relation with this, now we will continue with bronchopulmonary segments. Now you know lobes present in right lungs are three, in left lungs are two. What is bronchopulmonary segment? Bronchopulmonary segment, it is a separate respiratory unit in which segmental bronchus or tertiary bronchus terminate or supply. Therefore, bronchopulmonary segment is formed by this segmental bronchus or tertiary bronchus. We know trachea. Trachea will come down, then it will divide into two principal bronchus, right and left. These principal bronchi then divides into lobar bronchus or secondary bronchus. This secondary bronchus divides into segmental bronchi, yes, segmental or tertiary bronchi, and this tertiary bronchi will supply bronchopulmonary segment. Again, division and redivision of this tertiary bronchi will take place in the form of terminal bronchioles, respiratory bronchioles, alveolar ducts, alveolar sacs and alveoli for respiratory purpose. But this segmental bronchi, as forming bronchopulmonary segments, these are aerated by tertiary bronchus. It will form a pyramidal shape respiratory unit. Now, apex of this pyramidal shape bronchopulmonary segment points toward this root of lung, and base of this pyramid is in relation with outer surface of this lung. Now this bronchopulmonary segment, there is presence of segmental artery, segmental bronchus and intersegmental vein. How? These bronchopulmonary segments are separated by septa, and this connective tissue septum present in between this bronchopulmonary segment. In this segments, or you can say in this areolar septa, there is presence of pulmonary vein. Therefore, pulmonary vein is intersegmental in drainage, but tertiary bronchus, pulmonary artery are segmental in distribution. This is about bronchopulmonary segment. Now, which bronchopulmonary segments present in right lung and left lung? Right lung having three lobes: upper lobe, middle lobe and lower lobe. In upper lobe, tertiary bronchi will give three or will form three bronchopulmonary segments after its division: apical, posterior, anterior. In middle lobe, lateral and medial. Now in lower lobe, apical, medial basal, anterior basal, lateral basal and posterior basal. Therefore, in right lung, there are 10 bronchopulmonary segments. Left lung. In left lung, two lobes present, upper lobe and lower lobe. In upper lobe, bronchopulmonary segments, apico-posterior, then anterior, upper lingular, lower lingular, 4. Now next is lower lobe. In lower lobe, apical, anterior basal, lateral basal, posterior basal. In this lower lobe, there is no medial basal. Therefore, in left lung, 8 bronchopulmonary segments are present. Applied anatomy of these bronchopulmonary segments. Lung abscess formation. Right principal bronchus is more vertical, having wide lumen. Therefore, foreign body can be easily aspirated into right bronchus and in right lung. Now, in this, lung abscess is common inside, on this side. Where which bronchopulmonary segment? Apical segment of lower lobe and posterior segment of upper lobe. This is common site for lung abscess. Here, postural drainage is required. How? Give prone position to patient so that purulent discharge can come out easily through the opening of this bronchioles, segmental bronchus into this trachea so that it can come out easily. But this is not always possible. Next, tuberculosis. Tuberculosis is common in posterior segment of right upper lobe. Means in right lung, tuberculosis is common, but which segment? Posterior segment of right upper lobe. Carcinoma. Carcinoma is common in anterior segment of upper lobe. As in between bronchopulmonary segment, there are areolar septa. These acts as a barrier for spread of infection. But this is not always true in case of carcinoma and tuberculosis. This barrier is not effective. Therefore, tuberculosis and carcinoma can spread easily from one bronchopulmonary segment to other. Sometimes there is need for segmental resection. If you know location position of these bronchopulmonary segments, we can resect these segments. This is all about lung and bronchopulmonary segments. Thank you.